Hello everyone, welcome to Analytics School YouTube channel. This is session 10 in base SAS programming series. SAS provides us the flexibility that one can mix and match any of the input style for our convenience. And we can use list input, column input or format input or the combination of these input styles to read the messy data. And I would like to mention from my personal experience that there are very high chances of a question coming into a base SAS certification. So specifically for those people who are appearing for a base SAS certification program, they can get a question from this particular topic. Let's do an example. But before that, let's see our data first.
By now we know that if we are using list input method, one must read all the data in the record. Any missing data must be indicated with a period. And character or numerical data must be in a standard format. And character value should not be greater than 8 characters in length. Whereas, column input has various advantages over list input method. For example, delimiters are not required between values, missing values can be left blank, and character data can have embedded spaces, and character data can be up to 200 characters in length. And last but not the least, one can skip unwanted variables if they are using column input method. Whereas in format input, we can read dates as they are, as well as we can also read data if they have, for example, numerical data, if they have commas in between. So here, if you see in this data, as you can see here, Mumbai, San Francisco, Beijing, Tokyo, and Toronto, they are more than 8 characters in length. Moreover, there is a space between San Francisco. So we are going to use column input method to read this particular data. Whereas the country, as you can see here, India, USA, China, Japan, Canada, they are not more than 8 characters in length. So we are going to use list input method to read this data. And here we are going to use list input method again to read this numerical data. Whereas here you can see there are embedded commas between numerical values. So we are going to use format input method by using in formats and formats to read this type of the data. Now let's write the code and see how we can do that. As you can see, we have used column input style, list input style, and as well as format input style with the use of the format comma 9 here to read the raw data which we have seen earlier. Let's check our log. There are no errors with the log, and let's look at our output data. The output data is perfectly fine as we had seen our input data set. So in this way, we can mix different type of the input style to read our messy data. And as I said earlier, the people who are appearing for a base SAS certification, there are very high chances that you will get this type of the question in the base certification exam. So do focus on this particular topic. So guys, this is an end of session 10. In the next session, we are going to discuss about the modifiers. And with the help of the modifiers, we can read messy data in SAS. Thank you so much. Have a great day.